Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture Unit 3 Acceptance of Sampling Plans. In this, we define some terms used in acceptance sampling plans. First one is lot. A lot is the collection of units or items from which a sample is taken and inspected to determine its acceptability. It is found that lot formation influences the effectiveness of the acceptance sampling plan. Therefore, formation of the lot is important for the success of an acceptance sampling plan. So, here some guidelines for the lot formation, those are as follows. So, the first guideline is units in the lot should be homogeneous. So this means that the lot should consist of units produced by the same machine, same operators, using the same raw materials and approximately during the same time period. So this is the first guideline for the formation of lot. Coming to the second guideline, so that is units in the lots should be packed so that the shipping cost and handling risks are minimum. So this also makes the selection of units in the sample easy. The decision about the acceptance or rejection of all units of the lot is taken on the basis of the results of inspection of the sample. Therefore, the sample should be such that it is a true representative of the lot. And the next one is sentencing. So, what is the meaning of the sentencing? The act of accepting or rejecting the entire lot is called sentencing the lot. And next one is lot size. The number of units in a lot is called lot size. It is denoted by capital N. And next one is sample size. The number of units inspected to sentence a lot is called sample size. It is denoted by small n. And next term is lot quality. So what is the meaning of lot quality? The proportion of defective units in a lot is called lot quality or proportion defective. It is denoted by small p and is defined as small p is equal to number of defective units in the lot divided by lot size. So this is treated as first equation. From the definition of P, that means lot quality given by the equation 1, you should know that for the same lot size, as P value is increases, the lot quality is decreases. And next one is acceptance number. When a deal is finalized between a seller and a buyer, they decide on the maximum number of allowable defective units in a sample. This number is called acceptance number and this is denoted by C, small letter C. The rules for acceptance or rejection of a lot is, if the number of defective units observed in the sample is less than or equal to the acceptance number C, then the lot will be accepted. Otherwise, it will be rejected. Let us explain the terminology with the help of an example. So here, we are taking one example. That is, suppose a cricket ball manufacturing company supplies lots of 500 balls. To check the quality of the lots, a buyer draws a random sample of size 20 balls from each lot and accepts the lot if the inspected sample contains at most one defective ball. Otherwise, he or she rejects the lot. If the lot consists of 10 defective balls, find capital N, small n, P and C. So, based on this example, we have to define capital N, small n, P and C. So, in our example, the lot contains how many balls here? 500 balls. So, since the lot contains 500 balls, this can be denoted by the lot size. So, capital N is equal to 500. Since the buyer draws a sample of size 20 balls from each lot to take the decision about the lot. So, that is sample size. So, the 20 denoted by the size of the sample. So, the size of the sample can be denoted by small n. That value is equal to 20. And coming to the next one. So, the buyer accepts the lot if the inspected sample contains at most one defective ball. So, that the acceptance number. So, the acceptance number can be denoted by the letter C. So, this acceptance number C is equal to 1 in this example. So, this means the buyer accepts the lot if the inspected sample contains at most one defective ball. So, this one defective ball can be denoted by the acceptance number. So, that is C is equal to 1. So, and the question is if the lot consists of 10 defective balls. If the lot consists of 10 defective balls, we have to find out the lot quality. So, the lot consists of 10 defective balls. So, from the equation 1, so the lot quality here we have to find out. So, the lot quality is given by small p is equal to number of defective units in the lot divided by lot size. So, here the lot consists of how many defective balls? 10 defective balls divided by the size of the lot is 500. So, 10 divided by 500 we get 0.02. So, this is the lot quality. So, that you have learnt about the terms such as lot, lot size, lot quality, sample, sample size, etc. You may like to know how can we be confident that the lot of good quality will be accepted and a lot of bad quality will be rejected. We can answer such type of questions by calculating the probability of accepting a lot of specified quality. So, the probability will be 1 if all the units in the lot are accepted. And 0 if all units in the lot are rejected. So, the probability of accepting the lot is denoted by PA of P. PA of P, shortly, this can be represented as PA. Now, let us define probability of accepting a lot. So, this is simply denoted as PA. Suppose that the lots of the same size, say, are received from the supplier or the final assembly line and submitted for inspection one at a time. The lot is accepted if the number of defective units observed in the sample is less than acceptance number C. Otherwise, it is rejected. Suppose here we have to take a random sample of size small n that is drawn from each lot for inspection. If x represents the number of defective units in that sample, the lot is accepted if x is less than or equal to c, that is acceptance number. So this means that we accept the lot if x is equal to 0 or 1 or 2 or c. Therefore, we have to find out the probability of accepting the lot is given by PA of P. This can be denoted as simply or PA. This is equal to probability of x less than or equal to c. And this is equal to probability of x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 1 or x is equal to 2 or and so on or c. X is equal to c. This is treated as second equation. Since here the values of x, that is 0, 1, 2 up to c, are mutually exclusive events, from the addition theorem of probability, we have probability of x is equal to 0 plus, probability of x is equal to 1 plus, and so on, plus probability of x is equal to c. So simply here we have to write down the probability of accepting the lot. P of P is equal to, so we have to write this expression is summation x is equal to 0 to c, P of x is equal to x. This is treated as third equation. We can easily calculate this probability if we know the probability distribution of x. Generally in quality control, a random sample is drawn without replacement so that the number of defective units, so here the number of defective units can be denoted by x, that defective units are denoted by x in the sample. This follows hypergeometric distribution. However, we know that when the lot size, that is capital N, this is large compared to the sample size small n, that means capital N is greater than or equal to 10 into small n, the hypergeometric distribution approximates a binomial distribution with the parameters n and p. So here p is the lot quality. Therefore, the probability of getting exactly x defective units in a sample of size small n using binomial distribution is given by P of x is equal to x, that is equal to mcx p power x into 1 minus p whole to the power of n minus x. So this is treated as fourth equation. Hence, you have to substitute this relation in the third equation. Therefore, we get PA of P is equal to probability of x is less than or equal to c, that is equal to summation x is equal to 0 to c, P of x is equal to x. Now we have to substitute P of x value in this expression. So summation x is equal to 0 to c, ncx p power x into 1 minus p whole to the power of n minus x. Now we have to compute PA of P for using example. So in this example 1, already we are discussed in the previous slides, we have capital N is equal to 500 and the size of the sample n is equal to small n is equal to 20. Acceptance number C is equal to 1 and already we have to calculate the lot quality in the previous slides, that is P is equal to 0.02. Suppose x represents the number of defective balls in the sample. The buyer accepts the lot if the number of defective balls in the sample is at most 1, that is c is equal to 1. So that is already we are given in the example 1. Therefore, the probability of accepting the lot quality, that is p is equal to 0.02, is given by p of p is equal to probability of x is less than or equal to c. So here the value of c is 1. We have to substitute the value of c here, that is probability of x less than or equal to 1. So this means p of x is equal to 0 plus p of x is equal to 1. So this can be written as summation x is equal to 0 to 1, P of x is equal to x. Since the lot size capital N, that is 500 in the first example, is large compared to the sample size small n. So here the size of the sample is 20, that is n value is greater than or equal to 10 into sample size, that is 10 into n. So here xx approximately follows the binomial distribution with parameters n and p. So here p is the lot quality. So here the p lot quality value is 0.02. Now we have to substitute these values in this relation. So therefore we get the probability of accepting the lot of quality p is, for n is equal to 20, x and c is equal to 1 and p value is equal to 0.02, then we have probability of p is equal to p of x is equal to 0 plus p of x is equal to 1. So we have to substitute, so x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 in this binomial probability mass function. We get x is equal to 0, 20 is 0, the value of p is 0.02 whole to the power of 0, 1 minus p, that is 1 minus 0.02 whole power 20 minus 0. So this is the probability of x is equal to 0. In the similar way, we have to find out probability of x is equal to 1. So by the simplification, we get the value of probability of accepting the lot of quality p is, that is 0.9401. So this means if there are several lots of the same quality, that is p is equal to 0.02, about 94.01%, about 94.01% of these will be accepted, and about, and the remaining, so that is 5.99%, will be rejected. The effect of the lot quality on the probability of accepting the lot. Suppose in the previous example, the lot contains 20 defective balls instead of 10. Then the lot quality is, so P is equal to number of defective units in the lot divided by lot size. So instead of 10, here we have to take 20, 20 divided by 500. We get the quality of the lot, that is p value is 0.04. Now we have to substitute all these values in the expression pa of p. Now we get probability of accepting the lot quality, that is p is equal to, here we have to find out 0.04. So that probability of accepting the lot quality P is given by, so by the simplification here we have to get 0.8103. In this case, about 81.03% lots will be accepted, about 18.97% lots will be rejected. If we compare this probability with the probability obtained for p is equal to 0.02, we observe that the lot quality decreases, that is from 0.02 the quality, we get the probability acceptance value is 0.9401. So the lot quality P at 0.04, we get the probability of acceptance value is 0.8103. So here we have to observe, as the lot quality decreases, that is the value of P is decreases, the probability of accepting the lot also decreases. And next one, the effect of the acceptance number on the probability of accepting the lot. Suppose the buyer accepts the lot if the inspected sample contains at most two defective balls. So in the first example, we have to take the acceptance number C is equal to 1. So here we have to observe the defective balls are at most two defective balls, that is C is equal to 2. Then we get the probability of acceptance value is 0.9929. So this means if there are several lots of the same quality, that is P is equal to 0.02, then for the acceptance number C is equal to 2, about 99.29% lots will be accepted and about 0.71% of lots will be rejected. If we compare this probability with the probability obtained P is equal to 0.02 and C is equal to 1, we observe when the acceptance number increases, that means C is equal to 1 to C is equal to 2. So then the probability of accepting the lot also increases. That is, PA value is here. From C is equal to 1, we get the value of PA. This is probability of acceptance value, that is 0.9401. And C is equal to 2, we get the value of probability of acceptance is 0.9929. So the acceptance number, the value of C increases, that is probability of acceptance is also increases. Thank you.